हेलो माय डियर चिल्ड्रन, वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून। दिस इज एल के त्रिपाठी फ्रॉम लक्ष्मी प्रसाद मेमोरियल पब्लिक स्कूल गोलाबाजार। वेलकम बैक टू द न्यू वीडियो दैट इज फ्रॉम योर ज्योग्राफी पोर्शन। द टॉपिक इज पॉपुलेशन कंपोजिशन। व्हाट इज द पॉपुलेशन कंपोजिशन? दिस टॉपिक विल एनेबल अस टू नो अबाउट दैट। सो better for us to start this topic. Another important aspect of human resource besides its distribution is its composition. A study of the composition of population includes a study of the age structure. Population composition study enable us to study about the age structures also, sex composition, rural-urban settlements, rural-urban segments, occupational structure, literacy levels, as well as language, religion, and races or ethnicity. By study of this composition, we shall come to know about all such types of things which is the part of our structure, parts of our life, parts of our society. In various ways, through the population composition, we will come to know about different types of points as we have seen over here. First of all, the age structure. What is the age structure?
The age structure explains the percentage of a country's population in different age groups. A study of the age structure gives a direction to planning and development work in human resources. Normally, an age pyramid shows the segment of population in the age groups 0 to 4 to 9 and so on till 75 plus. While the numbers of males and females are shown on the horizontal axis, the age groups are depicted on the vertical axis. You will get the draft here. This is the pyramidal structure of the population composition. Age group pyramid, vertical to horizontal we shall study. And this is the matter to study in the classroom on the blackboard through demonstration and through the explanation properly on the board. But for your better convenience, this is shown here by your teacher. Rest, just returning to the school, we shall discuss about this. Normally, an age pyramid shows the segment of population in the age group. Again, we are seeing it 0 to 4, 5 to 9. And so on till 75 plus. These age groups are known as the dependent groups. मतलब ये independent नहीं है, स्वयं पर आधारित नहीं है, ये interdependent हैं, दूसरे पर आधारित हैं, क्योंकि इस age के लोग जो है खुद से कुछ नहीं कर पाते हैं, दूसरों पर इनको आश्रित रहना पड़ता है। वी कैन कॉल द एज ग्रुप 0 to 14 एज यंग और डिपेंडेंट। 0 to 14 जैसा हमने ऊपर डिस्कस किया ये डिपेंडेंट ग्रुप है, 15 to 64 एज द एडल्ट और वर्किंग एज ग्रुप। ये वर्किंग एज ग्रुप है 15 to 64, ये इनसे अपेक्षा की जाती है कि ये अर्न कर सकते हैं, लाइवलीहुड करेंगे और जीवन को सही तरीके से जी लेंगे। एज द एडल्ट और वर्किंग एज ग्रुप एंड 65+ एज द ओल्डर एज ग्रुप विच में अगेन इंक्लूड डिपेंडेंट। फिर से डिपेंडेंट हो गए 64 एबव जो है, मतलब 65+। इन ए कंट्री वेयर द एज ग्रुप पिरामिड हैज ए ब्रॉड बेस दैट नैरोज अपवर्ड्स, we can see that the highest number of people is in the younger age group. A high birth rate and a low infant mortality rate contribute to this. The younger age group is non-productive and comprises a large dependent population. This age structure is typical of developing economies like India and Bangladesh. Most African, some Asian and many Latin American countries also have this type of age structure. In a developed country, developed economic country, the younger age group is not larger than the working segment. This points to the fact that the birth rates are controlled, so there is more proportion between the working and dependent population. The UK, the US, Canada, Japan and most European countries have this kind of an age structure. In most developed economies we also see a larger old age segment than in developing countries. This is because of better health care and medical facilities in the developed countries, and so old people live longer. In the developing countries, the life expectancy is low because of poor medical and health care facilities and lack of proper nourishment. So, fewer people are found in the older age group. When the working age group segment is larger than the other two, it means more people to sustain and provide for the other groups. This group also contributes to a country's economic development and is usually larger in developed countries. Now the sex composition. Sex composition refers to the male-female ratio or percentage of male to females in the total population. It is calculated as the sex ratio, which is the number of females per 1,000 males. Understanding the sex ratio is important as it allows forecast of future population trends and therefore planning for the future population development. Ratios of 1,000 means that males and females are equal in number. If it is over 1,000, it implies more females than males. A favorable sex ratio. It is an unfavorable sex ratio when there are less females per 1,000 males. On the other hand, a more educated and developed society that considers there to be no difference between males and females will have a more favorable sex ratio. Literacy rates are determined by the percentage of the total population that is able to read and write. At the end of year 2000, about 80% of the world's population was considered literate. In the developing countries of the world, the literate population is lower, especially in the rural areas. In such economies, the female literacy is usually lower than that of males. In developed countries, almost the entire population is literate, and there is virtually no difference between male and female literacy rate levels. Occupational structure gives an idea of the number of people within the total population engaged in different activities to earn a livelihood. First is primary activities, which include agriculture, animal rearing, forestry, fishing, and mining. Secondary activities like manufacturing and processing. Number third, tertiary activities, which include services. Transport and communication and trade. The most developed countries, the greater is the percentage of population in the secondary and tertiary sectors. A greater percentage of people engaged in primary activities points to a developing economy. The rural and urban segments of the population are also important in planning development. While 48% of the world population was living in towns and cities in 2004, India had 72.18% still living in rural areas. Population changes. The population in the world has been growing at varying rates since the human first appeared on Earth. While man was dependent on hunting and food gathering for his food, the population grew at a very slow rate. With the Neolithic agricultural revolution, world population began to increase because of an assured food supply. Then, expansion of trade set the stage for a more rapid population growth, and in 1650, it is believed to have touched about 550 million. With the Industrial Revolution in the 18th century, we see the most remarkable increase in population as the resource base expanded and scientific and technological advancements improved the quality of life. Between 1750 and 1900, world population nearly doubled from 700 million to 1.7 billion. In the 1960s, the remarkable advances in medical sciences had a profound influence in reducing the death rate and expectancy all over the world increased. Though death rates declined considerably, the birth rates, especially in Asia and some countries in Africa, continued to rise. So, the greatest growth of population has been in the developing countries and continues to be so. In the developed Western countries, on the other hand, the natural growth rate of population has decreased considerably, as along with death rates, the birth rates have also fallen. So we have to see more about this type of study and explanation further ahead. So in the next video, we will get more information about all these types of facts. Till then, bye bye, have a nice day.